job.
Yeah. Talk a little bit about that shot that he took at the Alabama game, the step back.
Oh, man.
It's going through your
man.
Hands. It's like rolling through the play.
So, yeah, it was a one-point game. It's about a little over a minute left. You know, we had the ball, you know. We had to get a good shot. So for him to, you know, have the courage to, you know, make a great move, he had a little snatch back, made the guy slip a little bit, and then hit the shot, you know, put us up four. That was kind of the game clincher for us. And, you know, you see me on the bench, like behind the bench, like I kind of stand up when he makes the guy fall. Like I'm standing up, like jumping up and down, then he makes the shot. It was just a crazy moment, man, because we talked about before the season, you know, starting 6-0 and beating Alabama. You know, try to, you know, get revenge from last year's tournament game and also just be the top 10 team. So for him to have that moment and for us to, you know, come out with the win, it was a great moment for sure.
Elijah Joyner. I am the point guard for Iona men's basketball team. I grew up on the west side of Chicago, born and raised. I live with my mother for the most part. My stepdad came around when I was about 5 or 6 years old. Early in my life, my dad was in the military. My parents were separated, but I had an awesome stepdad and a great mom who, you know, kept my head on straight. I went to Curie High School. My freshman year, we had Cliff Alexander, and we was actually the number one team in the country. Only team to beat Ben Simmons and Mount Vernon. So, you know, being a freshman and them doing that, it only opened up doors for me. So I was able to, you know, continue being successful there. Won a state championship my junior year and received offers from all over the place my senior year. I ended up deciding to go to the University of Tulsa, where I spent 4 years, my undergrad years. Some of the best times of my life. I met a lot of great people, played some great basketball, and learned a lot under Coach Hafe.
Here we go. Inbounds pass. Rachel waiting, pitching it to Joyner. Joyner dribbling it up court. He's at the top of the key, fires a shot at the buzzer. Good!
Man, that's a crazy moment because that was my dad's first game at the University of Tulsa. And the day before, I was listening to a song with my cousin in the car, and it was called Picture This, because I never really pictured the moment, you know, my father being there, being excited, cheering the way that he was. And at that moment, I told my teammate, I'm going to set the screen, I'm going to flash to the ball, give me the ball, I'm going to make a play. When the ball left my hands, I knew it was good. I felt like God just took control of everything, and it went right in. I just looked up, and then I just like, wow, like I never pictured this moment. I hit the game winner, my pops is in the crowd, you know. It was a very emotional moment for me, but I was just happy that he was there, and I was happy that he could be a part of that.
Biggest question of all, what brings you to Iona? Like, you've been all around, Chicago, Tulsa, why New Rochelle?
I think there's only one answer to that question, Coach Rick Pitino.
Welcome to the Rick Pitino Show, featuring Providence College basketball coach Rick Pitino.
Ben Calpignotti gave up 2 threes because you're not containing the freaking guy.
He don't know anything about the game of basketball. Let's have an intelligent conversation.
Now, as soon as he dribbles, you don't wait for him to clear. You're gone. Hit that block.
You know, we just got to know each other in the summertime, so, you know, it's still growing, but, you know, just being, you know, in the car with him, just, you know, going places, just talking with him about, you know, not about basketball, just about life. Like, you realize, you know, he's really a great guy. He's really genuine. And, you know, just having that relationship with him is just something I can never think of as a kid.
He was able to convince me to come here. We, at the time, you know, we couldn't really do visits. You know, it was all Zoom calls. But, you know, out of all the schools that I spoke to, he sold me the most on being able to develop me into a professional basketball player. So that's the reason I came here, to play for him and to be able to learn from him, understand the game better. I'm a dog. I'm not scared of nothing. There's no fear in my eyes. Whenever I go out there, my goal is to win.
He's a big, strong point guard. You know, he's someone who can get in the lane. He's a leader. Like, you can tell from the first time, you know, all the guys were together, he was kind of the guy that brought everybody together and made sure that guys were, you know, happy and, you know, really a part of what was going on. So I can't say more about, you know, what he does on and off the court.
Coming here and being able to play for Coach Pitino and being around a good group of guys, guys that, you know, help me get better every day and motivate me, push me, and just make sure all in all that they got my back. And, you know, it was just a new place, a new environment. I was just happy to be here, you know, and I'm just happy that we could actually do something special here, and I'm just glad to be a part of it.